As you can see, it was a white wine, a Müller-Thurgau white wine, and the wine had itself no off flavor. We found higher contents of TBA in the air of a storage room where the screw caps had been stored. It was very problematic to explain to that winery that they have a problem because people, that's what I want to show with the picture, people don't realize that if they live in that area. You see, we found that TBP contaminated materials were all over in that cellar and in the air, and then he had a problem with his screw caps, but he did not want to realize that. We even did not taste and smell it because he lived in that atmosphere. Another case, we had TCA in a wine with synthetic stoppers. There's missing one, I think. Okay, no, that's the right one. When we analyzed the wine samples coming from the barrels and from the tanks, we did not find any TCA, but when the wine was bottled, we found higher quantities of TCA in the wine. So we had to look where it came from, and we found out that the TCA was coming also again from a roof timber which was in a room. It was from a ceiling material, from out of wood, and a wall which was out of wood. And the problem in this winery was that it was no problem for a long time of years. They never had any problems with TCA using synthetic closures. But then they installed in the bottling room a new heating, and the temperature in that room was rising like 2 or 3 degrees, and then they had this problem that all the room was contaminated with TCA, and the wine which was stored and the stoppers which were stored in that room for a short time before bottling were contaminated, and then they had a problem in the wine, and they did not have it in the tank before. After the removal of all those wooden parts, the